Okay, don't back. Well, note self. Don't set an alarm while you're making a video because it'll stop the video when it goes off. It's been probably an hour or so, but anyway, I just left it off while I was, finishing my battery recharging. I went inside and I actually tried to put the vein on my USB stick. I'm not going to leave it in there yet. And turned out UNET booting the app that I always used to do that for years. Won't run on Fedora 28. That's what do I have on there? Yeah, Fedora 28 on the one inside the Lenovo Wi-Fi. I remembered that once I tried to open it up. It just crashes. And there was another app I had downloaded. I even tried Etcher. I think it's called Etcher. And it has a Windows and a Linux version. And I tried it out. And it got a weird error. And it didn't respond well. You know, couldn't hardly close it. I had to force close it. It actually did act like. Once I got the error screen closed, I finally figured out you can't see everything on the. The graphics don't all work on the little apps. It's not very well written for Linux. I'll say that. And for Mate Desktop, anyway, maybe it works better in KDE or something like that, or XFCE, I doubt it, really, but I don't know, can't say, really, haven't tried it. But I fell around for at least 30, just the most of the 30 minutes, the last 30 minutes I was charging the battery in there doing that. Got cooler, cooled off quick, got pretty chilly getting that charger off the truck and everything. I stuck the, on a side note, I stuck the, I noticed I smelled gas. I cranked it just a little bit to see how well it would crank after I charged it the first hour and a half. I ended up charging 2 hours pretty much, a little more maybe. And I smelled a little gas, and I don't have the carburetor on. It's in here waiting for me to rebuild it. And I thought, well, heck, where's that fuel line pointing? You know, the fuel pump's mechanical, it's still hooked up. So I took it and stuck it in the intake manifold, and then I set a board on top of it to make sure it didn't jump out. And this time, it was cranking real good after, about 2 hours of charging. It was down to 3.20-something volts. So now it's back up to 13, a little over 13 volts, which should last for a while, just staying there. In the winter, they always go down quicker, even in Texas. And even with our weather, the way it is now, warm, hot, warm, cool, warm, cold, warm, cold. We had freezing weather for that for about a week here, just this last week. So anyway. Usually my batteries don't. When you drive the vehicle all the time, no problem. But when you don't drive it, you don't know for sure what it's going to do. Especially, the battery, I don't know how old it is now. 3 years, 5 years, I don't even remember. And I used to always use Interstate batteries. They would always last they're usually 7 year warranty. They usually last that long or a year or two. Or maybe if they were 5 years, they'd last 7 years or whatever. They usually last a year or two over the warranty. These batteries don't do that, these other ones. I got this one at Auto Store. I can't think of the name of it, Auto Store branded battery. But, I'm off on batteries and stuff. But anyway, it tried to kick over. It acted like it wanted to start. It sounded just like if you had the carburetor on it and it just was almost starting, but not quite. And I knew I would just sit there and flood it, so I just quit. I let it kick over about twice and then quit. And then I went up there to see if I'd made a gas go everywhere, and I could kind of smell it a little bit, but not as much as the first time. I didn't really, it's dark outside. We got a big light out over our driveway, which I can see what I was doing. And I do have a light I can take. I took it out there once, but to see the battery charger. But anyway, my plan was just to get the battery charged, not to work on the truck tonight. I should get myself back on day schedule, and the weather stays nice, I can do some things that thing is, I got, when I'm feeling better, I have 100 things I need to do, and I can't, it's hard to decide what to do then. So anyway, this I got started on while I was waiting on the battery to charge. And let me put the lid on the toolbox so that I won't accidentally mess up the cable to the phone. Have to keep it plugged in to keep it from going down. I really like doing live streams because then I know, that OBS Studio is a much more dependable app. Well, I'm not actually using it on the phone, I'm using it on the computer, but using IP webcam is a bit more dependable video app than open camera. And for one reason, it will just, well, you can set your settings to lots and lots. It's real powerful settings-wise, but it does, they don't always stay. It seems like every time it updates, something's beeping. There's a moth flying around. That's why I'm looking around like a cat sees a moth, you know? Something's beeping. What is it? It's not the phone. I don't get it. If it is the phone, the camera app's still recording. Okay. So anyway, I just left the IBM over here in the BIOS settings where I was trying to figure out AECPI standby mode. I had it on 3 and I thought, you know, 1 sounds like what I want. And so APM BIOS is on enabled. I can't remember a lot of this. Some of it I don't pay attention to more than what I need to know because I have trouble remembering everything. But should be enabled when your system supports APM. Support will be disabled if you don't. Well, I'm going to leave it disabled. It will. I think it's the computer beeping. I don't know why. I don't have other things on that could be beeping that I know of. Oh. I have a bug zapper, a little baby bug zapper up there. I wonder if it beeps when it kills a bug. I didn't think it did. It doesn't. I don't know what's beeping, but it's not the phone. I only have this one computer running. Okay. Standby timeout. Amount of time system needs to be in idle mode before. Yeah, it's disabled. I don't want to do that. I don't want to go on standby. It's a server. I don't like any of my machines going on standby, but through the BIOS. I don't like going on standby, period, much less through the BIOS, because then you don't even know what the heck's causing it. Hard disk timeout disabled, right, I don't want that. Last state, I used to leave it always on when it's the main server, but it's going to basically end up being my backup server, I think, so I put it on last state. Yeah, I turned on my little, I've got a heater up at the front that's on, and now since I had the door wide open to get myself cold, I'll turn this one on down here. Which is probably being heard in the video. So I'll turn it off now. Because I imagine this might be louder than me. Alright, now then. Power, last state. Power entry. What? Select the item set up. Activities which will be monitored for automatic power management. Yeah, I don't want any of those automatically power managed. Low power exit activity monitor. I don't want any of those on low, you know, exited. Automatic power on. Wake on LAN automatic. That's actually, you know, wouldn't mind that. If it does try to go to sleep, and if somebody, you know, when it's a server and somebody tries to access it, it'll at least try to wake up before they go, hopefully. Doubt it, but it wouldn't be fast enough. But you could do on disable, automatic, or primary. I'm leaving on automatic. And then serial port, ring detect. Yeah, there used to be serial modems before there were. Actually, well, the ones plugging into the phone line, well, they might have been considered serial. No, they weren't considered serial modems. That's when I got into the internet was with regular, you know. Like the first one I had was like, I think, a 14K modem. Then I graduated to a 56K modem. That was fast. PCI modem ring detect. Wake up alarm disabled. PC wake up. PCI wake up primary. Leave that because if you're going to use the Wake on LAN, that's a PCI card. Well, it's not a PCI card that's on board, but it's still considered PCI. Okay, now security. Oh, now we're exit. Okay, so the one thing that I changed that I think might make a difference, I don't think that changing from S3 to S1 will make a difference in it seeing the drives. I don't know what's going on with that. I think perhaps I messed up the devices. Let's see. There it is, IDE drives. both parallel and ATA, serial ATA enabled, native mode operation automatic, that should be good. Startup. Startup device. Now I don't remember what section. This is one of the it's quite a bit different. I mean, than most of the other BIOSes I've used over the years. Got a few extra features that kind of, I guess, some of them, it kind of sounds cool, and I had to think about it and and read the information to figure out if I even knew what they were talking about. It's more aimed at enterprise users than at desktop users. With the IBM, you know, that's pretty much what they aim for. Or at least on this kind of machine. This is what kind of machine this is. It's not a server, it's really a desktop machine, but I'm trying to make it into a server by putting on a server operating system. Okay, well, I wanted to review what I've done. I'm getting really hungry, and I'm beginning to, my brain is not working as good as it was an hour ago. So I'm just going to exit, save settings, and exit, and see if it sees the drives now. There's somewhere where most of them you can, before I exit, that didn't exit, so see if it sees the drives. I like it when you can go in there and see, there. Does not see the drive, but that doesn't mean it won't when you reboot. Doesn't see any drives. That's weird. Maybe I got it set right. Oh yeah, I changed the startup sequence. There it is, startup sequence. I changed it to automatic. I hit, I had it set manually. Well, I had it set to manual and it wasn't seeing them, so. Now it's automatic, but the weird thing is this PCI, LAN, and then IDO 1, 2, 3. It took out the USBs and stuff. I mean the CD drives, so it may not work at all. What was the number? Oh, primary 1, 2 automatic, 3 error. I don't know what the heck. Why you would use error? See, that's one something I don't remember ever seeing in any other machine. And I know that this doesn't work right when you say. Let's see, what if I try to put all CDEs in there now? Let's see. It doesn't work. And it doesn't say anything about like hitting control. I've tried it. The shift. It doesn't make it do it. Excludes. Now that'll work. Plus is what you usually use to add things back up to one of these menus. It just says X excludes, forward slash includes, and making sure I'm hitting forward slash. Shift 1 enables or disables. It doesn't do anything. Let's try the one on this side. Doesn't do anything. I did it. It's actually not where I had it. Oh, that made it go down to 1. Oh. That put something up there. USB CD-ROM. I don't have a USB CD-ROM. If I had one, that'd be great. Shift 1. 2, 3, 4. What about shift 4? No. It makes it go down there. And then when I hit the forward slash, it actually put it up there. But it doesn't do it that way. If they're not at the, what, do you, they have to be at the bottom? Shift plus 1. Shift 1. It doesn't do it when you do this. Whoops. You have to hit the one on the number pad, but that brings it down to. It's crazy. I don't have a SCSI. All IDE CD. I think that needs to be up there for it to work. shift 1. Oh, I think you have to hit 1 again to make it do it. Okay. Shift 1. No? Shift 1. That didn't do it. Okay. Now I don't know what's going on. Shift 1. That doesn't bring anything up there. USB CD-ROM. Okay, let's hit X on it because it will hurt. Taking it out won't hurt a thing. Yeah, it took it out. IDE. It didn't jump down to the bottom that time. It also doesn't work. Oh, shift 1. Oh, that time it did. PCI SCSI. That doesn't do it. That won't do it. So let's go back to automatic. I wonder if you hit shift 1. Enable. Now O is taken out. I think it's making it worse instead of better. Yeah, you could set up, do reset up defaults, and I may have to do that. F9, set up defaults. I need IDE O. It's disappeared out of there. Well, maybe it had O in there, I thought. I need IDE CD, or all IDE CD would be better, I think. And it used to be in there. Oh, now O1 and 2 is in there. Oh, there's more down there. You can't see them all. Okay. Oh, IDE CD. Okay. I forgot. I was at the bottom of the list. See, they've got more in there than you have to page all the way up to the bottom. IDE CD, USB HDD, and USB floppy disk. That should be enough. IDE CD, USB 01 and 2. That should do it, except for I really want that all CD in there. But I can't get it to go in there. Won't do it. Alright, I'm going to leave it like that. I still don't know if there's bound to be a place where you can see. Almost every BIOS I remember has a place where you can see. It's still doing the same thing. A place where you can see. I can put a CD in there again, I guess. Put one in there and leave it in there until I'm done messing with it. I don't know for sure which one will be working. Surely I didn't mess some kind of... That sure is scratched up. I don't guess I messed up wiring inside the machine, taking hard drives in and out and all that. CD drive. I'm almost certain I've seen it work with the CD. Sometimes when you reboot, and make that start working right and shut itself and everything. Not this time. Okay, getting tournament. Still recording at least. Let's unplug it. Well, this is not my goal, is to make this run right now. I have other goals in the house. The machine's sitting there for me. So I guess I'm going to end up having... I just don't like getting started on something and then have something not work and leave it like that. But what the heck? Okay, I booted it back up, same exact error. Let's see, F1 to repeat. I think it's F12 to get into BIOS. That moth keeps fluttering around here. Okay, enter setup. Alright. Startup sequence. That's what throws me off. You're in advance and it's on startup sequence, but it's not there. So you gotta hit enter. ADE CD, HDD. I don't see how I got it to. Let's see. Shift 1. Primary automatic error. Enables or disables the device, and then 1 is primary, automatic, or error. Didn't actually do anything. Primary, PCI LAN, 1, 2, 3, okay, 2. What it is you have to do to get it to... take over and do that. It doesn't say to hit shift or anything. Shift 1 jumps down to the bottom, and then I would think you could move around and then hit forward slash, but that doesn't do it. 1. That's back to like it was. USB hard drive, which would, in this machine, I think would be a USB stick would make it work. They were working. Because the otherwise you got USB CD-ROM, USB floppy disk, PCI LAN, PCI SCSI. I actually have a PCI SCSI card and a SCSI drive that I took out of another machine that was its main drive. And it will work in other machines, but it's only like 3 gigabytes or something. I don't know why I can't get all... I don't want to take IDE CD out. Maybe that's why I can't do it, but I'm scared to take it out. I'm scared I won't get it back in there. Guess it doesn't matter. But shift plus 1. Maybe it does shift plus 1. Let's try that. Well, it didn't cause it not to work, and then, you know. Yeah, I don't think you're supposed to. It does say shift plus 1, and the others say, well, that's still, I believe that's what they mean. It won't do it again. It won't add, and there's 3 more slots. I think there's something wrong with it. Includes, so you should be able to just hit whatever you're supposed to hit and make it. Oh, wait. Yeah, it says down, select a device, and plus, and move. Oh, to move it, yeah, right, up and down. But, F and R specify the device fixed or removable. Oh, okay, fixed or removable. Fixed or removable, so that's removable. That's removable. It's just beeping at me. It's not letting me tell it anything. But you would think that shift doesn't make any difference. It's forward slash, not backslash, and I'm hitting forward slash. I'm used to forward slash because Linux uses forward slash, or Windows uses backslash. And I use Linux all the time. What I did a while ago is I hit shift F1, and then when I hit, maybe I was doing more than I thought I was doing. I was trying a bunch of stuff. I kept holding down shift and doing this and doing that, but it says shift plus 1 enables or disables. Okay, enable. And now you would think you'd be able to go back up there and add it. Do it again. Yeah, okay. Shift 1 enables or disables. So that's enable. It doesn't beep either when you do that, so. Jumps all the way to the bottom when you do that. And they don't just keep dropping down each time you put one in either. They go in their own order. That's actually what I want, except for one thing, and that's I know that all IDE CD used to be up there. I guess I can hit the X and see if I can. Maybe you can only have one type. I'll try it. Okay. Okay, it took it out. Now let's shift 1 to enable it. Nope. I'm gonna guess that I can't put it back. Let's see. Maybe you enable or disable when it's up in the top row. Yeah, now I can't get it to go back up there like before. So now primary. Is automatic. Now it's back on PCLN. Don't have any CD in there. PCLN in there. I can take it out. I can take them out. But I can't put them back in there. Now I don't have any CD in there. Shift plus 1. Shift plus 1. That doesn't do it. Shift plus 1. And it jumps off of it when you do that. That won't let you put it back in there either. Okay, I guess I'll do the... See if I can put IDE CD back in there. Okay, now it doesn't have any USB or anything, but I did hit 2 for automatic. Now it could be that I put that on cable select and the hard drive is not being seen because it's on cable select and it needs to be on master. That could be. But it's not a bootable operating system on it, but I'll try that. First, I'm going to do the default BIOS settings. Parallel ATA. I think both should be good. Primary, secondary, disable. Yeah, I think so. Serial ATA. Enable. Native mode. Choose channels. We place native mode, automatic mode, disable. Channel is placed in native mode and only if necessary. Some operating systems not supporting. Okay, the operating system would just be jacked up if that wasn't. Yeah, I don't see the list of the drive. Like, usually it's the first page. Oh, there we go. That's where it is, and it says not installed. Okay. So it still doesn't see any drives. So let's go exit. I don't know. I don't think we've got anything that'll work, but we'll just try it and see. That cookie is wore off, though. My coffee has no sweetener in it, so it doesn't give me anything but a little caffeine and some good taste. Except for when it gets cold, it's not as near as good. Okay, let's try 12. I remember having trouble with this, but not this kind of trouble where it doesn't even see the hard drive, so. I'll never get the dryer on. And just to make sure there's plenty of noise, I turned my heater on because I'm getting cold. Okay, we're still recording at least. Well, I've set the F9 to default. My mom was out here putting stuff in the dryer. I didn't want us to keep talking. She probably just wondered if I was talking to her. Set hit F9, set defaults. Now it's trying to boot to Pixie Boot. Over the network. And you gotta wait on that. You can't interrupt it. I don't know how to take that out. That X will work to take that out. But maybe all the regular drives will be in there now. We'll see. And then I can fiddle with all my other, tweaking my own settings later. If I can just get it to see the drives like it should. It may be that hard drive needs to be on master. Not too many of them do. Well, I don't know. Yeah, maybe there's more than I, it might be more than I remember over the years, but okay, no operating system on Pixie Boot. Now it's doing something, well, maybe a little different. It's got a blinking cursor. That's probably trying to boot to the hard drive, and there's no, it may be empty, I don't know. Let's try and pick, it rebooted. We gotta get into the BIOS and stop that Pixie Boot. That's no good. First I'm gonna put a CD in there again. It's gonna work. Oh, there's one in there. The bang. Well, obviously it didn't, either didn't see it, or I'll put the Fedora 23 install CD in there. But the CD's not working right, it's not doing like it should. Okay, we'll do F12 again. I'm afraid that dryer is so loud that all the foam in here. Inner setup. Oh, now we got something. Oh, disk drive A and PCIM, or inner setup. So it sees disk drive A, it must have turned that on, and there is no A drive in this thing. Okay, it doesn't see the hard drive, so it must need to be on master. And yeah, it's enabled to diskette drive. That's normal. USB is all good. Parallel ports and good. the video, put the video to 8 megabytes. Put that in aperture. If I want to put, you know, a PCI card, I want it to at least take everything that it can. Okay, that looks about the same. I don't want Pixie Boot enabled at all. Base code. I'm going to turn that off this time because I don't want any, it's got a MAC address now. I don't want it wasting time trying to do it. Numlock on, fast, disable, disconnect. Oh, you don't want the, yeah, you want that. This option allows the system to run without a diskette drive enabled. You gotta have that enabled, because I don't even have a diskette. The defaults wouldn't even work for this machine the way it was built. Keyboardless, I don't really want that. I like it to beep, but tell me I don't have a keyboard plugged in. Power on, quick. Net logo. Option keys enabled. Yeah, I want the F1 and all that. Option keys. I want legacy. Okay. Actually, that wasn't. Yeah, I didn't know legacy. I like that. Starter device menu. Automatic startup sequence enabled. Okay, that's good. And then. Oh, that was it. Okay. Save scene. Now then, save and exit. Now I don't think it's going to work. I think the hard drive must need to be on. I think the hard drive needs to be on. I'll put up my. Yeah. I don't know. I'll do it later. I left it on. Dang. Well, let's put it up. Turn it off. But I noticed that. Let me put up my. Multimeter that I was using, you know, to test the battery with, so I can have room to set stuff over there. Where it's sitting. I've got so much stuff in here that I don't have room to set in this garage. Now I'm just having trouble. Okay. Trying to hurry, so what I'm doing? Going slow. Batteries and I think it's a transistor tester adapter for the lid in there. Turn that off. Well, at least it turned off good. We're still making a video.
Yep.
Okay, so I'm gonna. Oh yeah, I don't have to take it. All I have to do is mash that button, take that off. So maybe it was a good idea to do that. Now you can open this up, and I may have to take the hard drive out to read the BIM. I can't remember. I may need another set of jumpers. But at least I can get the hard drive out quick and easy. Okay, let's see. It requires two jumpers to do this. Put it on masking. I know you can't see that. I can try that. Oh, okay. That's really weird. Wait, masking. Oh, the black ones are for slave. Okay. This is also another hard thing to... I don't think it can be seen. Well, anyway. Yeah, it looks to me like it's way too dark to be read. Let's get where I can read it. Okay, master is the one, two, third over from the kind of placeholder ones. Oh, where's the single? Oh, the single. So it's right next to the single. There we go. Right next to the single. Now I need a tool. Something small. I think my little tiny needle nose are in the... Oh, I have a pair that's pretty small. Smaller than those. I don't know where I put them. I went through this whole toolbox because I lost it. I was trying to solder a circuit board the other day, and I got areas hot that I didn't realize I got hot. And I was trying to get solder off of a dumb thing. I was tapping it, and I was right in this area on my little sawhorse sort of thing. And I tapped it, and I know that I noticed there was a resistor missing after a while, and I know I made it fall off. So, let's try it with the regular size ones. I think maybe I can do it with them. I got some of the little bit smaller too. Okay, one it next to the single. It's actually... Well, maybe I can get to it. This is one of the ones where it's... Couldn't get it with my fingers for sure. Some of them you can get with your fingers, with fingernails, but not this one. I have some very small ones in the house that I keep working on computers. This heater keeps going on and off, on and off. Something weird about it. I can't remember if the ones I'm thinking about are... Yeah, they're in the toolbox, I think. I'm kind of confused right now. These are actually... Those are not needle nose, those are actually flush cut wire cutters, but I didn't want to, I was real leery that I was going to cut it. There is some, copper in there, and that's what I was getting a hold of, was the copper. See, now it was a pain in the butt to get this in this front bay, but it actually worked out good. Well, we'll see. Look at those pins and make sure I haven't injured any of them. Yeah. It's all good. Buttons don't work without this front on here anyway, so you might as well put it there. That's not a cover that came with this, but it works good because it lets you have a little airflow. You can move it, leave a crack and get a little airflow. But it doesn't actually fit perfectly. Okay, let's try. You should at least see the hard drive and try to boot or get the boot error saying rubs are broken or something. Or I'm sure it had some sort of Linux on it. Windows. This is a Windows system? Oh my gosh. That's what it was. It needed to be on master. This is going to be Windows 7, I'll bet you anything. It's actually trying. It's going to get to a camp boot because it's not the same machine it used to be. Okay. Well, at least the hard drive works now. I think I'll go back into BIOS and see. Did I need a CD in there? I won't pop it out because I know it's not a Windows CD. That is a Fedora 23 net install. So see if the CD's working. Well, it's not going. It keeps trying to load Windows files. Have fun. Well, okay, so I got a hard drive to work at least. I didn't know it had Windows on it. 30 gigabyte hard drive. That would have been Windows. That might have been. No, it's probably 64-bit Windows. It was. That drive was in another machine, and I remember now. Dual core machine, Windows 7. And it was 32-bit, but I think I reformatted it with 64-bit. I think it's hung. It does take a while for it to load up and install. Windows can't start, but this is a single core 32-bit. I don't believe it can run Windows 7 at all. Yeah, I'm going to hit escape and see if it goes into. Well, no, let's hit key. Yeah. In Linux, you can go and see the command line by just hitting an arrow key or something. Let's hit escape. I don't know if it'll do anything. At least you know we're seeing the hard drive. Hit escape and it. Now, okay, I'm going to hit control and delete and see if I can get. I think it was F10 to get to the boot screen. It never did reboot. So I'm going to hard set it down. Just to know the drive still works. I'm going to try getting to the boot screen this time. See if I can tell if it boots to the CD. It's still kind of boot Windows. I will try getting the BIOS again. Maybe the legacy mode doesn't give you as many options. I saw, the option. Yeah, IDE or inner cell. Okay, F12 gives you those options. Inner cell. Now, it does not seem to see. Oh, it's got USB flopping. USB HDD. Ah, IDE CD. Let's hit plus and see. Yeah, we can move it up to the top. I don't have a USB floppy to be used. I'm going to take that out. USB HDD, yes. That would be, that says the Maxter. PCI LAN, that's actually on. It's not, well, I'm going to leave it because I turned off Pixie Root. But, and since this is so hard to get things, you know, back in there, I guess the automatic did what it saw available there. Yeah, IDE0 and IDE2, that's all it really should be. And, IDE CD, it put those in there, and USB HD, I don't remember now. Well, I know PCI LAN wasn't in there. So, the automatic seems to be the only way it work. Okay. I mean, it should work, but it's the only thing that's working. So, leave it like that. See if it will see that CD now. Could be that the CD drive is not leaking. When they don't want to open right and all that, and you have to force them, sometimes they just don't read until they start opening. They may not have to open and close on their own, but they need to not have been forced back in. That should, if anything would read in here, that Fedora 23, that would probably read everything. See, it's not shutting. Okay, I'm going to leave it open. Sometimes it'll get, if you leave it open and reboot it, sometimes it'll start working. Okay, save settings. Save and exit. I don't know if you can hear me when I don't turn 4G at all with all the stuff going on in here, especially. Yeah. That's a pain in the butt. I will have to make. I know it tries to boot the USB, so if I'll make a USB to install from, then I should be able to do it. I mean, you could let that run forever, and it'd probably come up to you. You do want to try to fix Windows, but it's not going to run. Single core is not going to run Windows 7. I don't want Windows 7. I don't think the drive is even coming on trying to do anything. Oh, it tried to go in. There we go. Let's see.